And now we're joined by Ruby Walsh on the phone. Of course, the sad news that Kauto Star has lost his life after a paddock accident. Ruby, we're talking sad circumstances. When did you hear about the news?
Oh, Paul Nichols rang me this morning. Early to tell me. But yeah, look, it is a sad day, but he was a wonderful horse and a brilliant horse to be associated with.
Exactly. Let's celebrate what it was that he achieved. Can you encapsulate why people are rightly, in my opinion, saying that he is one of the greatest racehorses of all time?
Well, I'm extremely biased. I think he is, without doubt. But I had the pleasure of riding him. Look, to me, he did everything. I mean, from going to winning in Hay.com, winning the old run over 2.5, to winning the Betfair Chase, drop back, win the Single Creek, step up and win a King George, then go on and win a Gold Cup. I mean, to me, that season was amazing. And I suppose throughout his career, I guess a good horse is a sound horse for a start, but the longevity he had to win 5 King Georges, running 6, win 5, win 2 Gold Cups, he was just an amazing horse. He was brilliantly trained and he was a pleasure to ride.
He was brilliantly trained, and also he was really aggressively and imaginatively campaigned. Clearly you need a horse of his brilliance to be able to do that, but as you said, the versatility that he showed was just outstanding.
Well, I thought it was. I mean, that first year they won a Gold Cup, I mean, to me that year when he won the Tingle Creek, he had voice for his daddy's beaten coming away from the railway fences, and he was the champion chaser at the time. You know, he sluiced up in the King George, and he showed great stamina and battle to win the Gold Cup. He just had everything. He had some really hard races, he took some really heavy falls, and he kept coming back. You know, he was a true heavyweight, and he was a pleasure to be associated with him.
What was your best moment with him, and what was the moment that you felt most low with him? Because clearly, as you said, it was a hugely successful career, but it had highs and lows.
It did have highs and lows. I don't know about the lows. I guess he was lucky to get up when he fell in the champion chase, and he was very lucky the year he fell in the Gold Cup. He took a very, very heavy fall that day. You know, he took a bad fall at school when we won one morning as well. And I guess there were low points, but great points that he got up. If I was to ride one race on him again, I'd love to ride the Betfair Bowl on him again in entry. I definitely left that one behind me. But
why? What do you still think about that? What did you do wrong? What would you do this time?
I went too soon on him that day. But anyway, that can't be changed. But he was just an incredible horse to be associated with, and I loved riding him, and I really enjoyed every day I rode him.
And has there been ever a horse to compare before or since?
I don't think so. I'm too young to remember Arkell, and I think it's very unfair to compare horses from different eras. But in his era, he was the best. He had the longevity. He won the most races. And I think it's some feat by any horse to turn up and win any race 5 times, let alone be at a Grade 1 King George.
Absolutely. We're looking at the reception that you got that day from the crowd. That must have been an amazing moment. How many people came to Kempton that day? How focused they were on Kauto Star? What did that feel like?
That was amazing. But the Haydock before, that was the same. I mean, God, the crowd in Haydock, when he won his last Betfair Chase, they lifted the roof off the place. And the same in Kempton when he won his 5th King George. But I guess at that stage, it's the same thing in sport. He'd been written off and he was the underdog. Mm. And then people really appreciated him. But that's just the way sport is. That's human nature. But I enjoyed every day with him. I mean, his 2 Gold Cups were brilliant. Every King George, Tingle Creek, a couple of days in Down Royal and Paul Bottom to Ireland were brilliant as well. I have nothing but great memories of him.
And what was his character like as a racehorse?
I think you'd really want to ask Clifford that. Clifford Baker, I'd say, knew him better than anybody. I can't say I overly enjoyed having to ride him out in Ditchy. He wasn't a great rider on the roads in Ditchy. He was quite spooky, and you know, he took his chances when he was schooling. But on the race course, he was dead straightforward. He had everything. You could drop him in, you could make the running on him. He just had everything, did he? I guess the good horses were easy to ride, and he was definitely very easy and a pleasure.
Ruby, thank you very much for sparing the time to pay tribute to Kauto Star. We're going to enjoy and celebrate many of his best moments during the course of this afternoon. Thank you for sparing your time and your superb words.
Thank you.